Krishna, I live in Sanjurgam. I will talk about the highly effective experience for Persian
pronunciation.
Then outline of my presentation. Firstly, a short historical remarks about human characteristics and some good data about this characteristics. The main part of my presentation will be about supporting bibliographic evidence for Esalen and Kuiper visualization. And certainly, short remarks about Middleton and post-Middleton characteristics and some conclusions. I would like to remind that Professor Borescov has initiated the study of the chromium oxide characteristics at the beginning of the 60s of last century. Chromium oxide catalyst is very traditional composition, but at that time it was discovered by Hogan and Phillips company that this catalyst can produce a very, can proceed very unusual chemical reaction, the formation of high density polyethylene, linear high density polyethylene. After a special procedure of preparation and activation. Very young PhD student Yuri Ivanov has studied this, has begun the study previously in the laboratory of Professor Borescov in the Moscow, and then since 1963 in the Institute of Catalysis, where he organized the lab of catalytic polyethylene polymerization. And he has received very interesting new results about this catalyst, and one of them in 1967, he and his friend Gennady Klavertov has formulated the very new pioneering idea about formation of the surface chromite formed at iteration of chromium trioxide is the surface hydroxyl of alumina and silica at high temperature in activation of the catalyst. They consider this species, surface species, as active component of this catalyst, and these species are determined the unusual thermal stability of the chromium oxide and unusual catalytic properties of this catalyst. Later, this idea was confirmed and used in the many papers, and some of them are listed here. According to this scheme, formulation of the surface chromate as the interaction of chromium oxide with silica hydroxyl groups, it's possible to see the different type of chromates are formed in the surface of the catalyst. Monochromates, dichromates, and polychromates. And the surface monochromates are considered the selective component of this catalyst in the most of publications. But there is not so much direct experimental evidence about the real structures of chromates formed in this catalyst. And it was interesting to find that experimental method for to separate the formation of different types of chromates. And it's possible to analyze the situation if you can measure the amount of surface hydroxyl groups involved in this reaction and compare this amount with the content of chromium in the catalyst. We have recently studied the interaction of chromium trioxide with silica and composition of the surface chromates using the TRIS method. It was necessary to use a special procedure for preparation of the catalyst, interaction of the chromium oxide vapor under vacuum at different temperatures, temperature with silica dehydroxylated at different temperatures. It was possible to observe directly the interaction of the chromium trioxide with silica, the decreasing of so this is improved after this interaction. And then calculate the amount of hydroxyl groups involved in this reaction. We have studied this situation for different types of this model catalyst. Prepared this silica hydroxylated at different temperatures and with different chromium content. And we have found surface trichromates are formed at dehydroxylated at high temperatures, higher than 600 centigrade. And this catalyst, which contains the chromium less than 1%. This catalyst possesses the maximum activity, and therefore we can conclude that the surface dichromates and trichromates, but not monochromates, are the active component of the chromium oxide Phillips catalyst. The formation of surface chromates is only first stage of the catalyst formation before interaction with this polymerization medium. After interaction with it's well known situation that after interaction with acetylene, surface chromates are reduced with formation of chromium 2 compounds. It's possible to reduce the catalyst by carbon monoxide and analyze this model catalyst, the structure of the surface species in this model catalyst. If you consider that dichromate and trichromate are formed in this catalyst, it's possible to propose that polynuclear species of reduced chromium compound are formed in this catalyst. But in literature, are considered, discussed the another situation, monochromite as active component and formation of the mononuclear reduced chromium species as precursors of active centers. But in, if we consider the dichromate and polychromite as active component, it's necessary to propose that dinuclear and trinuclear surface structures of chromium 2 are the real precursors of active centers. We have studied the CO absorption, the CO absorption on the reduced chromium structures 1, 2, and 3, and we observe the formation of bridging carbonyls in this catalyst together with terminal carbonyls. The formation of bridging carbonyls is the undirect evidence about formation of the polynuclear structure in this catalyst. So again, we can conclude that dinuclear and trinuclear surface structures of chromium 2 are the real precursors of active centers in this catalyst. Chromium oxide catalysts have been optimized and modified during a long period, and at the moment about 30% of high density polyethylene are produced with this catalyst. What is the reason? What is the reason of this situation? The reason is the excellent combination of polymer properties at processing, extrusion, blow molding, and technical performance of final polymer products due to the multi-site nature of chromium oxide catalyst. Multi-site nature of this catalyst is determined the broad molecular mass distribution of the polymer produced. Then there is different kind of the species, and one of them produces excellent one in situ ethylene trimerization, and this commonomer modifies the polymer structure via copolymerization. And then this catalyst has very high copolymerizing reactivity and more homogeneous commonomer distribution in comparison with Ziegler Natta catalyst. And the last point, very unusual for another catalyst, the formation of the long chain branches in the polymer, which determines the better processing of this catalyst. So, there is a
Next part supported the Bernatta catalyst for olefin polymerization. And nowadays it's the main catalyst for polyolefin production. The simple composition for this catalyst, the most simple composition of this catalyst, titanium tetrachloride supported on vanadium chloride with 3 alkyl alumina as protective. This catalyst for polyethylene production gives them kind of polyethylene. And more complicated composition, the same company together with special stereo-regulating additives, electron donor compounds in the composition of the solid catalyst, give 1 and another electron donor compound in the polymerization to improve the stereospecificity of this catalyst. The most part of high density, nowadays the most part of high density polyethylene and linear low density polyethylene and about 95% of polypropylene are produced over the supported Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Activated magnesium chloride is the main component of the supported high-active Ziegler-Natta catalyst, titanium magnesium catalyst. But what is it activated magnesium chloride? Sure. Just 0.5 surface area, but maybe more important, the disordered is very amorphous structure. The size of primary crystallized of this support is about 2.5 nanometers in 0.01 direction and 6.15 nanometers in 1.10 direction. And high concentration of the surface low coordinated 4 and 5 coordinated magnesium ions, which have their use acidic properties. It was it's very interesting to know about the content of this reactive size of activated magnesium chloride, and about 10 years ago we have analyzed the situation using the different method, low temperature CO absorption, DRIPS data about CO absorption and absorption of the stable nitrous radicals like TEMPO and analyzed by ASF method. And we have found there is a high concentration of the DRIPS acidic site in the activated magnesium chloride is in the range 1-2.5 micromol per square meter. This amount of DRIPS acidic site is close to the amount of titanium species absorbed on the catalyst and some another additives. It's some of the evidence about important role of the Lewis acidic size in the formation of this catalyst. There are different structures of titanium species and another additives in the titanium magnesium catalyst are proposed in the literature and discussed in the literature. But in that case, linear magnesium chloride crystal are considered and the low coordinated magnesium ions located in the lateral faces of magnesium chloride are considered as reactive site. But if we consider the activated magnesium chloride, we can propose that the structure of the reactive site may be not the same as for ideal surface. But unfortunately, there is no direct experimental data about the structure of Lewis acidic site in the activated magnesium chloride. We have done recently DFT theoretical study of the structures of the low coordinated magnesium ions in the activated magnesium chloride. And the main results of the study for relaxed surface, the geometry of reactive size for relaxed surface chlorine magnesium chloride angles and length of magnesium chloride bounds differ for relaxed surface from the ideal surface of magnesium chloride. And then we have calculated the ERS spectra of carbon monoxide absorbed on the data about carbon monoxide absorb, I agreed well with simulated data for relaxed magnesium chloride lateral phases. Also, it's very important that absorption energy give us for relaxed surface and ideal surface. It means that acidity of Lewis acidic size for relaxed surface is much lower than for ideal magnesium chloride crystal. But different structures have been proposed for titanium species and stereo-regulated components on the surface of the craters, and these structures considered for ideal crystal. But according to these results, probably it will be necessary to revise the structure of the species using the data about structure of the reactive size on the relaxed surface. Another point of our study of this catalyst is the kinetic investigation, and it's very important to get data about the number of active centers and total rate propagation for detailed kinetic study of SN, of olefin polymerization, and for analysis of another item for catalyst preparation. Many years ago, we have proposed and developed the special procedure for determination of number of active centers as catalytic olefin polymerization, the quenching of polymerization by carbon monoxide labeled by carbon 40. Carbon monoxide inserts into the growing polymer chain, polymer chain connected with titanium ion in the catalyst, and after quenching, it's possible to analyze the reactivity of polymer and determine the number of active centers in this catalyst and calculate the constant rate propagation. Well, some data about number of active centers and constant rate propagation for titanium magnesium catalyst. First, very important question about effect of magnesium chloride support for kinetic parameters. There are shown data about number of active centers and constant rate propagation for traditional titanium trichloride catalyst and supported titanium magnesium catalyst. Supported catalyst has much higher activity, and this very high activity is determined by the sharp increase of number of active centers. And increasing of number of active centers is the main reason of the high activity of the supported titanium magnesium catalyst. The reactivity of these centers, constant rate propagation, is similar. Much more complicated situation at propylene polymerization, because in case of propylene polymerization, the fractions of polymer with different stereo regularity are formed. For example, atomic fractions, low stereo regular fraction, this polymer dissolved in isopentane DP5 fraction, DP7 fraction, low stereo regular fraction, soluble in borine heptane, and isotactic polypropylene. But it's using carbon monoxide method, it's possible to determine the number of active centers with different stereo specificity and constant propagation for different stereo specific centers. And then shown the combined effect of CP and PP values on the yield of the different fractions with different stereo regularity. The square of the color square on this picture is proportional to the yield of different fractions. First conclusion from this result, that constant rate propagation for high stereo specificity active center is much higher than in case of low stereo specificity centers. Next point, the simple catalyst without any stereo regulating component has a very low amount of stereo specific centers. About
approximately 15%. But after addition of these catalysts, the stereo-regulating components, DBT oscillate inside of the composition of solid catalysts, and DLQ-dimethoxysilane in the polymerization medium, the number of stereospecific centers increases. And increasing of these centers is connected with this transformation of low stereospecific centers to high stereospecific centers. Therefore, activity of these catalysts, these electron donor additives, is higher, the total activity is higher than the activity of the catalysts without stereo-regulating component. There are different methods for preparation of the supported titanium modulating catalysts. Some of them illustrated here in this scheme. And all of this method, using this method, it's possible to prepare high active catalysts, and catalysts with high stereospecificity. But very important point is the preparation of the catalysts with optimal morphology. And it's not so easy to prepare the catalyst. For example, this method is possible to use for preparation of the catalyst with optimal morphology. So, one of the big problems for preparation of good catalyst is to prepare the catalyst particles with optimal morphology and to keep high activity and stereospecificity. Some additional notes about morphology of the catalyst and polymers. Modern technology of TP production, slurry polymerization, treatment, hydrocarbon, bulk monomer, and gas phase polymerization. And according to this technology, these polymers are produced as particles with a size within the range 0.1 to millimeters, the particles. And morphology of the polymer particles is key technological parameter because it determines the productivity of the polymerization reactor and another equipment of polymerization and the stable operation in the polymerization process. Incident morphology, optimal average particle size, narrow particle size distribution, no fines, and high bulk density and low ability of polymer power. How is possible to handle the morphology of polymer particles? Only by morphology of the catalyst, because morphology of polymer particles is determined by morphology of the catalyst particles via replication phenomenon. Every catalyst particles, these particles with size 20 microns, transform to the polymer particles, the size about 400 microns. And there is a connection between the shape and architecture of the catalyst particles and polymer particles. Small aggregates, separated aggregates of the catalyst includes homogeneously in the inside of the polymer particles. Some more detailed data about the mechanism of replication will be presented in the oral presentation of Gennady Bukatov in this conference. We found the special procedure for preparation of the catalyst with excellent and controlled morphology. Our procedure is based on the specific magnesium organic compounds as an initial component, and then special procedure for transformation of the magnesium organic compound to the sulfur, and then preparation of the catalyst. High activity, high stereospecificity, control of molecular mass and molecular mass distribution, and the most important, and it is a specific property, excellent and controlled morphology. Using this procedure, we can prepare the different type of the catalyst for slurry polymerization, for different polymerization process, for gas phase polymerization, for bulk polymerization, and different by this particle size. For polyethylene production.
gas phase polymerization, slurry polymerization. It's possible to use supported catalysts also for gas phase polymerization for production of linear low density polymers. Titanium leading catalyst, catalyst for polyethylene production has the most simple composition, no stereo control indicators. But they need we need to find the, another procedure, another method to control the chemical composition of this catalyst, because it's necessary to control molecular mass of polymer, molecular mass distribution, and polymerizing reactivity, and polymer structure. And again, very important point, morphology control. First situation, the effect of titanium content in the titanium magnesium catalyst on the activity of this catalyst. We have found that activity of catalyst doesn't change of titanium content in the white region, but catalyst with very low titanium content has much higher activity. The increasing of activity for catalysts with the low content of titanium is determined by very high content of number, very high number of active cells. It's interesting to know the activity of the catalyst with low titanium catalyst, Ziegler-Natta supported catalyst, is much higher than activity of the non-supported metallocene and post-metallocene catalyst. This value is about one order higher. Another very important to know about molecular mass and molecular mass distribution produced with titanium based catalyst with different composition. And it's possible to control molecular mass distribution with low titanium content. Low narrow molecular mass distribution. The most effective way to control molecular mass distribution is the substitution of titanium titanium compound to vanadium compound. And in that case, it's possible to get the polyethylene with broad molecular mass distribution. Vanadium vanadium catalyst, unlike of titanium magnesium catalyst produces polyethylene with broad and bimodal molecular mass distribution. Very important point about copolymerization, especially polymer distribution in the copolymer produced. As a typical situation for titanium magnesium catalyst, very non-homogeneous distribution of polymer in the polymer fractions with different molecular weight. Low molecular weight, high content of commonomer, high content of branches. But in case of vanadium magnesium catalyst, you have more homogeneous distribution of copolymer in the copolymer. It's very important for polymer quality, and it's more close to the non-metallocene catalyst. That is shown on the scheme of preparation of the supported titanium magnesium catalyst for polyethylene polymerization, and we have developed the different type of titanium magnesium catalyst for different polymers and for different kinds of polymers via a control of transition metal compound and control of polymer morphology. Well, one of the last pictures, very shortly about metallocene and post-metallocene catalyst, because it's very new and very important class of new catalyst. We can see that there is much more transition metal compounds involved in the polymerization process in composition with the traditional Ziegler-Natta catalyst, where titanium and maybe vanadium only active, resurrective component of production of polyethylene. In that case, if we we can find the appropriate ligand, which is key element for formation of the structures with any transition metal of the compound. And another very important point, the optimal the selection of optimal activator for formation of the active structures, ion pairs or highly polarized structure. This new catalyst has the homogeneous active synthesis, single side catalyst, and produces the polymer with zero molecular distribution and homogeneous common distribution. And another point, precise ligand and transition metal control of molecular structure of polymers and new types of polymer produced via this catalyst. But supported catalyst needed for technology, and it is the main point of search at the moment for more wide application of the metallocene and post-metallocene catalyst. And finally, I would like to show the distribution of the different type of polyolefins and the role of different type of the catalyst for production of polyolefins. Huge amount of polyolefins produced, and very high growth of the production of polyolefins, 7%, and annual in the last, last 5 years, and it, many experts say about the same growth in the next decade. The total production of polyolefin like this pyramid, and this pyramid can be divided on the three sections. First section, commodity, traditional and modified traditional catalyst, mainly zirconium supported catalyst, has a very strong position for production of commodity, and its situation will be constant for the future. But another second section, a special commodity. There will be the competition between zirconium and supported metallocene and post-metallocene catalyst in this area. And second, less area, the speciality. The special kind of polymer, and it's possible to prepare this polymer only over metallocene and post-metallocene catalyst. And the special place for only for this catalyst. But anyway, we see that there is many open window for research and development, both for traditional catalysts and for new metallocene and post-metallocene catalysts. Well, and I would like to thank my colleagues and colleagues, Dr. McInnes, Dr. Simikareno, Gennady Bukatov, Artem Barabanov, Alexander Potapov, Yulia Cheska, Sergei Sergeyev, and Mikhail Matskov, who have done the experiment and who are in the real process of the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Dachow. If we're working up with a very short question, I think we can accept it. Are there any very short questions? Thank you very much again.